Hi, I'm Benton Block with the Beaded Wood Florist. Today we're going to talk about wood and water, wood and moisture. For the most part, a wood floor can take some moisture, but if it gets flooded, it has to be repaired or torn out depending on how much water it's got. Well, how do you know how much water is in the floor? How much is too much? Good question. The difference between wood floor installers, wood floor mechanics, wood floor finishers, who are professionals, and those who are not, are the ones who actually use a moisture meter, and they use it every week, not just once in a while. This is a wood floor moisture meter, and what it does is it's an electronic meter, and it'll tell you how much water is in the floor, so you know how much is too much or how much it should have. And this is the brains of it, and it's a little meter, and you take the cap off, and you'll notice two small prongs here and a button. These two prongs look something like snake's fangs, I guess. And what they do is they'll send out a small electrical charge from this side to that side, something like an ohm meter. And what it does is this, once it knows the kind of wood, you set the species of wood floor into this, and it'll tell you how much water is in the wood floor. This is a sample, and it's a piece of oak. I've already set it for oak, so I set it down, and I'll push it into the wood, and it tells me that it's 7.0% moisture content. That's about perfect for a house. Sometimes it goes as high as 10 or 11, depending on how well the air conditioning does in the house. But that's a normal floor, 7, 8, or 9. That's what we see a lot here in Louisiana. And I picked that up over the years to know that's what a wood floor should read in a conditioned space. Now, if the wood floor gets wet, I'll test the top, but this just tests the top surface of it, not below that. So I know what the surface is. That's only the very top of this. Well, what if I want to know how wet it is all the way through the wood? And in most cases, a wood floor is nailed to either a plywood subfloor, or it's nailed to a 2x4 or a 1x4 subfloor. It's nailed into something. And I want to know if that's wet, if the plywood under it is wet. Well, how do I know that? This has a hammer attachment, and it has the same two prongs, and these are an inch and a half long. So once I put it into the wood, it will test not only what the oak is, the oak flooring, but it'll test down to the plywood. And you can have prongs that are as long as these prongs are 2 inches. So that will test all through the floor, down to the plywood, to the very tip or the very top of the concrete floor. So it tells me how much wood, how wet that wood, how much water the oak flooring, the top finished floor, and how much water the plywood has absorbed. Plywood is usually a little bit higher. The wood might read 7 or 8, and the plywood might read 12 or 14 if it's dry. And what does that? The glue in the plywood screws with the number, so it gives it a false reading. And usually the wood floor on top, if it's wet, might be 7, the bottom of the wood floor might be 12, and the plywood might be 25. Because the water goes from the top to the bottom, the gravity pulls it all the way to the concrete slab. And since it can't get out of the concrete slab, it stays there at the bottom. So you find out where the oak floor is wet, where the top floor is wet, where the plywood is wet, and that's how you know how much you have to tear up. There's times you can save it, but most of the time when it's that saturated, it's useless. And you have to tear it out, replace it with a new one. But don't accept any wood floor man telling you the floor is wet until he tells you what the moisture meter numbers are, what the moisture content is. That way you know how big the repair is and what it should be. Your insurance adjuster will want to know these numbers too, so write those down. That's all for today. Thank you very much.